Good afternoon and welcome to Performance at St. Paul's from St. Paul's Episcopal Church in Key West. And welcome to From the Organ Bench, Part 2. Last week we concentrated on music, hymns, and hymn settings appropriate for Holy Week. This week we will hear hymns and settings with Easter texts. At Easter, we hear a lot of joyful music, sounds of trumpets, vast choirs, huge congregations. A lot of our traditions certainly changed this past Sunday. But in this setting of the hymn tune, Abbot's Lay, with the words, God is love, let heaven adore him, we can hear the trumpets calling, Christ is risen. This is a setting by Michael Burkhart, another composer and organist like Paul Montz, well known for his hymn festivals. Easter is celebrated throughout the world, and often the music is influenced from the sounds and rhythms of the people. We will now hear a Tanzanian spiritual, Christ Has Risen, Alleluia, a setting from Anne Krentz's organ. 400-year-old text, Good Christians All Rejoice and Sing, has been beautifully set by Jane Holstein in this next selection. She is a well-known concert organist, composer, arranger, and for over 20 years has served as the editor for Hope Publishing, a family-owned publishing company that specializes in Christian music for over 100 years. This setting also includes the hymn, The Strife Is O'er. I hope that you enjoy it. We'll now play a setting of the tune Coronation. We know this most commonly as All Hail the Power of Jesus' Name, number 450 in our 1982 hymnal. This is a setting by organist and composer Joseph Payne.
Thank you.
have to let it all hang out. The Easter tune, That Easter Day with Joy Was Bright, has been delicately set to music by Dale Wood. Mr. Wood composed a prolific volume of choral works and hymn tunes, compositions for handbells, harps, and organ. Listen to this simple, quiet, reflective arrangement. The first verse of hymn 193 states, "That Easter day with joy was bright, the sun shone out with fairer light, when to their longing eyes restored, the apostles saw their risen Lord." Christians to the Paschal Victim, we hear this next setting by James Byrie. With trumpet and fancy rhythms, this setting is just for the keyboard. You may not be familiar with the melody. I thought I'd play just a smidge of it. It's number 183 in our hymnal, 1982 hymnal.
Thank you.
One of my favorite melodies is hymn number 192, This Joyful Eastertide. Arranged as a chorale trio, this is set by Paul Bowman. An American composer for well over 50 years, Mr. Bowman died just last April at the age of 100. My final offering to you today is a setting of our hymn number 182, Christ is Alive, Let Christians Sing. This is a setting from Kenneth Koch, Professor of Music Emeritus of Concordia University in Wisconsin. Another parish musician at heart, he taught conducting, choral literature, composing and arranging to undergraduate and graduate students in the church music degree program. You might recognize this piece. I played this as a piece this past Sunday morning for the postlude. I feel it's appropriate to close today.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for tuning in today. I have missed each and every one of you these past several weeks, and hopefully we will see each other again soon. Join me next week as we check out the organ here at St. Paul's. It is a remarkable instrument in a remarkable city. It is the southernmost pipe organ in America. I hope to see you then.